myself Usha Rani, biology lecturer, Vishwamanava Composite PM College. Hello students, in last class in molecular basis of inheritance we discussed about a concept that is called as transcription process, and even the process that is called as the transcription which occurs in prokaryotes. So transcription andre enu? So here the process which involves the synthesis of RNA over a DNA template, that is called as transformation. It can be also defined as the genetic information from DNA strand has been transferred over an RNA, that is called as transcription. So last class alli now transcription unit do diagrammatic representation bardu describe madidvi. Process of transcription anta tagondre adalli first one to, that is called initiation anta karuttivi. So initiation is a starting process. So where by the help of RNA polymerase, which consisting of a core enzyme called as a sigma factor, where it is helpful for recognizing the promoter. So ee tara iron has finally promoter annu antha reachinna yaru recognize maatare RNA polymerase. So by the help of a sigma factor, so where it come and bind to a specific region called as promoter, that is the initiation anta karibodu. So elongation anta tagondre by the help of RNA polymerase enzyme the length of mRNA has been extended by the addition of an ribonucleotide triphosphate anta karidivi. That is a ribonucleoside triphosphate add aagidre RNA synthesis agutte, that is called as elongation. So where rho factor anta karidivi, elli rho factor irutte, so a rho factor iro jaga idu sigma factor. So this is the rho factor. Rho factor iro jagadalli enagutte terminates the transcription, that is a mRNA synthesis. So these are the steps that they are involved in transcription. So a transcription which occurs in prokaryotes and even in eukaryotes, but last class alli now discuss maaridhu transcription in prokaryotes okay. So adanna now representation tagondre, so over the double stranded DNA mele particular agi when the RNA polymerase enzyme it binds, it results an unwinding mechanism. So unwinding mechanism adhula it results an synthesis of an mRNA. So where mRNA synthesis agadana enanta karidivi transcription. Transcription aagtidangena this RNA was involved in translation in prokaryotes, because there is no differentiation of nucleus and nuclear membrane. So direct cell lo anta bandra genetic material in DNA irutte, so RNA synthesis maadi protein synthesis alli involve agutte cytoplasm alli. But eukaryotes alli ondu svalpa complex nation na note aagutte. So ishtu navu last class alli okay ivattina class alli navu discuss maadbekagiro concept, that is a transcription in eukaryotes. Transcription in eukaryotes. So eukaryotes are the higher individuals, so where the organisms which are having a true nucleus. So it really specifically mentioned maatabandre, so this is a cell where it consisting of nucleus. So inside the nucleus it consisting of a genetic material. So where this genetic material by the process of replication it synthesizes a new DNA. So over this DNA the RNA has been synthesized. So this RNA from the nucleus it has been transcribed to the cytoplasm, where it has been bound with the ribosomes for protein synthesis. Eukaryotes alli transcription aagidmele translation agutte, but prokaryotes alli transcription nadithane irutte adra jothege translation start aagbekante anta karibodu. So whereas the RNA that has been synthesized in prokaryotes, it was not undergoing any further process. Directly they are involved in translation. Prokaryotes alli in mRNA synthesis agutte, it has been directly involved in translation. Adu further yade process alli undergo agala. Adre eukaryotes alli idu svalpa complex nature na process, because RNA it was undergoing further process photosynthesize protein mechanism anta karibodu. So adakke namu illi diagrammatic representation tagondre, so this is a double stranded DNA. So when it has been bounded with an RNA polymerase enzyme, so ilia RNA polymerase enzyme bind aagirutte, RNA polymerase. So when it has been bound, it was synthesizing an RNA. So then what the RNA synthesis happened. But illi RNA specific aagi structure ga svalpa differ martivi na. Ee tara irutte. This one patta. So where this RNA, ee RNA ga now kelagade bandukondre matte differentiation ee tara bandukondre. So this is a primary transcript anta karide. So the RNA that has been synthesized in prokaryotes now adana RNA transcript anta karide. But the RNA that was synthesized in eukaryotes, it is not a functional particular again function agala, because it was undergoing further process to form an functional mRNA. So here the RNA that has been synthesized by this mechanism, it consisting of two genes, literally idana exons anta bakoli. Exons ili madhya iruvana introns anta bakoli. Exons and introns, this is a 5 prime region, this is 3 prime region. So ee 5 prime region alli m anta barutto gpp anta varu. This is a m, small letter m, capital alli gpp. So ee kada idanna, so idanna navu hn rna anta varu. This is a hn rna. So next one, there is an RNA splicing. RNA splicing. Splicing and the mechanism are next one. Look now, 5'MGPP. Here is the mechanism. Next one. That is a poly A tile and the poly A tile. So, you know, so you know, this is a polyadenylation. Polyadenylation. So it is a capping and the process. This is a capping. So ega in the body one RNA. This is a functional mRNA. So it is a functional mRNA which is having an 5 prime M GPP cap and poly A. So in the process now transcription in eukaryotes for diagrammatic representation. So where the double stranded DNA helix, when it has been binded with an RNA polymerase at the promoter region over the template strand. So template strand mele promoter region ke RNA polymerase bind that. By this it was synthesizing an primary transcript which consisting of exons and introns of the region. So the RNA, the mRNA that has been synthesized by the RNA polymerase in eukaryotes, firstly it is not a functional, it is called as hnRNA at the region. So hnRNA, it is a heterogeneous nuclear RNA, the nascent RNA after transcription that has been fall off, that is called as hnRNA. So ee hnRNA really consisting of an exons and introns and the sequence in it. The exons are the coding sequence. Introns are the non-coding sequence. So exons are the coding sequence agirutte, introns are non-coding sequence agirutte. So in hnRNA it was showing a process called as capping ante karide. So ee idu capping ante. So usually the RNA sequence or DNA sequence having a polarity. That is from 5 prime to 3 prime and 3 prime to 5 prime. So in the 5 prime region alli capping anuvantha process agutte. So where it has been binded with GPP cap anta karide. That is a guanosine triphosphate. Guanosine triphosphate addition agutte. So it has been combined with an amino acid that is called as methionine. M ano indication eno methionine. So idu capping mechanism aagumela. So next eno RNA splicing anta kalithivi. So now the functional coding sequence ashte beku namage non coding sequence bara. So hagage enagutta introns ligo aagbeku exons join aagbeku. By the help of spliceosomes. By the help of spliceosomes, the introns have been removed. Introns galen madutte remove aagutte. And by the help of ligase enzyme, the exons have been joined together. RNA splicing alli spliceosomes ina help moolaka the introns have been removed and the remaining exons have been joined together. The exons are the coding sequence where they have been joined together by the help of an enzyme called as ligase that to form a functional mRNA. So functional mRNA ante kondre ili capping mechanism adu jothege splicing mechanism nadithu innonde adu tailing mechanism ante karithe is called polyadenylation ante karithe. So where this is a property of eukaryotic mRNA consisting of poly A type. So more than 100 number of an adenine sequence so continuous agi irodana now poly A type ante karithe. So ili eukaryotes alli namu yagara process nadithu. The transcription unit that has been produced in an eukaryotes consisting of exons and introns. So this gene is called as split genes anta karithivi. So eukaryotic gene na vena anta karibodu split genes anta karithivi kaana it consisting of an two types of genes that is called exons and introns having coding sequence and non coding sequence anta karithivi. So idagale yava process occur agutte first step anta kondre that is called capping mechanism anta karithivi. So capping mechanism alli enagidappa at 5 prime region so GTP has been added, there is a guanosine triphosphate has been added by the addition of an amino acid called as methionine. So next step we know tailing mechanism. So tailing mechanism at 3 prime region polyadenylation mechanism has been added where the number of nucleotides but A and O has sequence so many than addition agudana now tailing mechanism agutte. So next process anta kondre that is an RNA splicing anta karithivi. So by this mechanism RNA splicing ee mechanism anta introns galu remove maadi ligation anno anta process inda ligation anno process inda exons galu en maartive join maartive that leads to the formation of a functional mRNA. So these are the steps that are involved in transcription in eukaryotes. So here the functional mRNA that has been synthesized in eukaryote this is called as monocistronic mRNA. This is called as monocistronic mRNA. So what is meant by monocistronic mRNA? Mono nothing but single. So the mRNA having an information to synthesize single protein at a time. ಒಂದು ಟೈಮಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದೇ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್ ಸಿಂಥೆಸಿಸ್ ಮಾಡುವಂತಹ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ನ ಹೊಂದಿರುವ ಎಂಆರ್ಎನ್ಎ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಮೋನೋಸಿಸ್ಟ್ರೋನಿಕ್ ಎಂಆರ್ಎನ್ಎ. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ವಿ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಆನ್ ಪಾಲಿಸಿಸ್ಟ್ರೋನಿಕ್ ಎಂಆರ್ಎನ್ಎ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರೊಕ್ಯಾರಿಯೋಟ್ಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಟು ಸಿಂಥಸೈಸ್ ಸೆವರಲ್ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್ ಅಟ್ ಅ. ಸೊ ವೆರಸ್ ದ ಮೋನೋಸಿಸ್ಟ್ರೋನಿಕ್ ಎಂಆರ್ಎನ್ಎ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಫೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆನ್ ಯುಕ್ಯಾರಿಯೋಟ್ಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಟು ಸಿಂಥಸೈಸ್ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್ ಅಟ್ ಅ. So this is about the transcription in eukaryotes. So iga transcription alli mechanism of capping tailing splicing ligation anna mechanism aadumanda so complete functional mRNA synthesis aagutte adare prokaryotes alli direct mRNA synthesis aagirodana nodidre. So ishta aadumanda that is a differentiation between the transcription in prokaryotes and eukaryotes only. Differentiate between transcription in
prokaryotes and eukaryotes. So last na we know diagrammatic representation kondidive adu the simple mechanism tosta unda. So this is an structural gene which is called as a TF. This one structural gene which is also called as template strand. So this was directly involved in the synthesis of an RNA. This is called as mRNA. By process called as transcription. So where this mRNA was directly involved in a synthesis of protein by a mechanism called as translation. So last class in diagrammatic representation bandidu adu simple agi torisidru process alli eukaryotes anta kodre. So this is a structural gene. So this structural gene it was synthesizing an RNA which is called as hnRNA, consisting of exons and introns, where it was undergoing an RNA splicing, where introns have been removed and exons have been combined together to form a functional mRNA. So ee process alli splicing jothege capping anuvantha process nadeyutte matte tailing anna mechanism kuda nadeyutte. Capping, tailing and even splicing. Next one, ligation. So these are the steps that occurs in eukaryotes. The mRNA that was synthesized in eukaryotes, now it was involved in synthesis of a protein by the process called as transcription. So the mRNA that synthesized in prokaryote is called as polycystronic mRNA. Whereas in eukaryote it is called as monocystronic mRNA. So is representation in our differentiation is active ko bodo. So the transcription nothing but the transformation of genetic informations from an DNA template to the RNA, or the synthesis of RNA by the help of DNA template. So whereas in prokaryotes, so the transcription unit that has been synthesized is called as a polycystronic mRNA. Adhe eukaryotes alli thondre it was synthesizing the transcription unit called as monocystronic mRNA. So property, prokaryotes property polycystronic mRNA, eukaryotes monocystronic mRNA. So whereas in prokaryotes the structural gene directly was synthesizing the mRNA. So where this mRNA was not further undergoing any process for translation. So whereas in eukaryotes the capping mechanism occurred. The capping mechanism was absent in prokaryotes. Capping alone, that is the GPP cap that has been added at the 5' region. Whereas tailing, there is a polyadenylation on the tail added. That is polyadenylation absent. Poly A tail in an mRNA, it is also a characteristic features of eukaryotic mRNA. Poly A tail is absent in prokaryotic mRNA. So RNA splicing ano mechanism nadeyutte, RNA splicing mechanism akkaragala. So where the hnRNA that has been synthesized consisting of exons and introns, so here the RNA that has been synthesized, there is no differentiation of exons matte introns iralla, hangage particular sequence of process aadmele functional mRNA synthesis agutte, it is direct synthesis agutte, transcription aagtidange translation start agutte. But after the completion of transcription, the mRNA is involved in translation in eukaryotes. So this is about the differentiation of transcription in prokaryotes and eukaryotes. So next one, that is transcription and reverse transcription in a process. was transcription. So transcription is the process of synthesis of an RNA by the help of DNA. So DNA RNA synthesis are the transcription. So that RNA DNA synthesis is called as reverse transcription. So this mechanism, the RNA acts as a genetic material in some of the viruses. Last class already. So there is example TMV, there is a tobacco mosaic virus, polio, HIV. So and even a bacteriophage, they having a genetic material that is called as RNA. So the RNA genetic material is one of the virus which consisting of an RNA as genetic material, they are called as retroviruses. Retroviruses. So the virus which consisting RNA as a genetic material, they are called as retroviruses. So here one example. It is cell. This is a cell. When this cell has been infected with the retrovirus, so it is retrovirus genetic material RNA. When it was infecting the cell, so it is infect maadi tashna idalliro genetic material cell olagade entry aayitu. During infection, so the retrovirus, it transfers the genetic material into the cell. So in the cell, this RNA, it was undergoing a reverse transcription. So RNA, when it was incorporated into cell by the process of reverse transcription, it was synthesizing a DNA. Reverse transcription is the synthesis of DNA. So here the enzyme that has been utilized, that is called as a reverse transcriptase enzyme. So reverse transcriptase enzyme, the RNA synthesizes a DNA in the cell. So RNA is then also DNA synthesis. So this DNA, it incorporated into host of the genome. So genome nucleus, whatever DNA is entry. In some of the organism, when this viral DNA, it incorporated into the cell, it remains constant and remains inactive. Specific agates for the duration, they are not undergoing replication. But in most of the cases, when it incorporates inside the cell, that is inside the genome, it was undergoing replication, that is synthesize many viral DNA. So this viral DNA, again by the process of transcription, it synthesizes an RNA. So this RNA, again it synthesizes protein by the process called as translation. So when inside the host genome, when the viral DNA starts replicating, the cells, it was undergoing rupturing mechanism. So cells olagadage yavaga specific genome activity deactivate agutho, along with the genomic DNA, the viral DNA is also replicate. So that was resulting the rupturing of cells. Cell rupture agutha, that is called as lytic cycle. So in some of the organism, it become inactive for specific duration. After that, along with host genomic DNA, it is also undergoing replication. That is called as lysogenic cycle. Lysogenic cycle. So this lysogenic cycle, it terminates with lytic cycle. So swalpa dina inactive state alli idantha DNA, along with genomic DNA jothe replicate aadaga, it was resulting in lysogenic. Replicate aadmele enagutte, it was resulting the rupturing of cell, that was concluded with a lytic cycle. So this is about a reverse transcription. So in reverse transcription, a specific kaagi na bakwa adare. So this is an RNA. When it has been introduced into a host of an individual, it synthesizes a DNA by the process called as reverse transcription. So this DNA, it synthesizes an RNA. binding mechanism called as transcription. So this RNA, it was involved in the synthesis of protein by a mechanism called as translation. So this reverse transcription process has been described by scientists called as Tallman and Baltimore. So Tallman method, Baltimore and all reverse transcription mechanism described. So this is about a reverse transcription. So ivattu transcription anno mechanism alli prokaryotes, eukaryotes, differentiation matte reverse transcription agutte. So idagala next concept that is called as genetic code anta baruttu. So what is meant by genetic code? So it is a code language of genes. It is a code language of gene. So where this concept has been proposed and coined by a scientist called as George Gamow. George Gamow. So he proposed and put forth the concept that is called as genetic code. So genetic code under it is a coded language of gene. Gene nothing but the unit of inheritance. So inheritance mechanism alli navu odiradenu by a process of replication and even by a process of transcription. Ili replication no process alli enagutte the DNA was synthesizing a new DNA. That is where the nucleotide is capable of synthesizing a new nucleotides. So whereas in transcription, so ili replication alli enagutte DNA, it synthesizes a DNA. Whereas in transcription, the DNA it synthesizes a RNA. So both mechanism erdu bande. You know, where here the nucleotide is having an information to synthesize another nucleotide by a process of replication and transcription. So whereas the translation it involves the RNA is capable of synthesizing a protein. The protein is consisting of an building blocks called as amino acid. Here, the genetic information that was present over the RNA, it is capable of transforming those composition for synthesizing protein by the help of building blocks called as amino acids. So this is called as translation mechanism. So ee sequence na vyakili genetic code anta explain martidivi andre, so by the help of several experimental proof the genetic code depict agutte. So usually the genetic information has been transmitted through a DNA. So the DNA having a nucleotides that is called as A, T, G, C. There is a four letters that adenine, thymine, guanine and cytosine. So these four sequences they are the base for a genetic code. So ega four sequence ena idappa, but the number of amino acids, so eshtu amino acids da, we already know that there are 20 amino acids da. So that has been classified into essential and non essential amino acids. So here only are four nucleotides but 20 amino acids da. So four nucleotides kuda 20 amino acids ke combined agutte inge. So here there is a specific codon system has been defined by the help of George Gamow. So for his another scientist name called as Hargobind Khurana. And Marshall Nirenberg. Francis Crick, etc. So these are the scientists helped so to depict the genetic code mechanism. So idralli Hargobind Khurana yen martare andre, so they synthesized the RNA chemically. ಸೊ ಆರ್ ಎನ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕೆಮಿಕಲಿ ಸಿಂಥಸೈಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಸೊ ವೇರ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಮಾರ್ಷಲ್ ನೈರನ್ ಬೋ ಸೊ ದೇ ಯುಟಿಲೈಸ್ಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದ ಯುರಾಸಿಲ್ ದಟ್ ಟು ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಶಿಯೇಟ್ ದ ಆರ್ ಎನ್ ಎ ಸಿಂಥಸಿಸ್ ಸೊ ಆರ್ ಎನ್ ಎ ಸಿಂಥಸಿಸ್ ಆರ್ ಎನ್ ಎ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್ ಸಿಂಥಸಿಸ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಅನ್ನೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಬರೀ ಯುರಾಸಿಲ್ ನ ಮಾತ್ರ ತಗೊಂಡು ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆರಿಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಪ್ರೂಫ್ ನ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಸೊ ಈ ಬರೀ ಅವರು ಯುರಾಸಿಲ್ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ತಗೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ರೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು 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 ಅಂತ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಬರೀ ಯುರಾಸಿಲ್ ಯುರಾಸಿಲ್ ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಏನೂ ಇಲ್ಲ ಆರ್ ಎನ್ ಎ ಸಿಕ್ವೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಟ್ ಯು 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 ಯಾವ ಅಮೈನೋ ಆಸಿಡ್ ಗೆ ಕಂಬೈನ್ಡ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಅವರು ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫಿಕ್ ಆಗಿ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಲ್ಲ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಕಂಬೈನ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಅನ್ ಅಮೈನೋ ಆಸಿಡ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಫೀನಾಲ್ ಅಲನಾಯಿನ್ So phenyl alanine is an amino acid that has been combined with an uracil. That is an U U U letter. So now we will look at types of more letter li parthi jive. Adane na genetic code na features ali otta parthi jive. So ishto introductory concepts anta tagondre. So the RNA that is synthesized over the DNA. So the DNA where it was directly involved in synthesizing RNA and RNA it was synthesizing a protein. So here the sequence that are present on DNA and RNA and protein anta tagondre so adanna now differ martta bartivi so next concept barkoli so here idu DNA template DNA template so which is called as single stranded DNA nam enanta karthi DNA template so RNA is usually a single stranded RNA na kumana single stranded So DNA mele synthesis aagu RNA. So RNA mele synthesis aagu adu protein. So but protein usually it has been consisting of an amino acid. So the amino acid has been brought by an another RNA called as tRNA. Amino acid na tagon borovare yaru tRNA. So hagagi next one to that is a tRNA template. So idana enu anta kalithivi mRNA template. So here the DNA template may you want the nucleotide sequence example for that there is an A T G bandidivi G A T C A T and A C C moor moor letters na separate agi barkondidivi so this is a specific characteristic features of a genetic code the sequence that are present over the DNA they are called as code So DNA mainly on the sequence na ve anta karithivi code anta karithivi So whereas from over the DNA the RNA has been synthesized which RNA that's an mRNA So mRNA mele sequence yaad barutte A ge opposite na yavaglu T barithivi but RNA irodinda A has been showing complementary base pair with U for T is A for G C So G ge matte C A ge U T A C ge G U A U G G. So the sequence that are present over the RNA, that is the mRNA, they are called as codons. The codons are the sequence that present over the mRNA. So either E mRNA mele barovaru tRNA that comes and bind with that along with amino acid. So idu bara sequence A opposite. So U ge A U G G A U C A U A C C the sequence that have been come and bind with that tRNA over the mRNA they are called as anticodons anticodons the sequence which are present over the DNA they are called as code over the RNA they are called as codons and over the DNA they are called as tRNA they are called as anticodons ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ಸೋ ಇದರ ಬೇಸಿಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ನಾವು ಡಿಪಿಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಸೋ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಓದ್ಕೊಂಡು ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆನ್ ಸೇಲಿಯಂಟ್ ಫೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಜೆನೆಟಿಕ್ ಕೋಡ್ ಬರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಸೋ ಸೇಲಿಯಂಟ್ ಫೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಜೆನೆಟಿಕ್ ಕೋಡ್ So it will be first one. That is a four-letter depiction. Four-letter depiction. So we already know that the genetic material that is called as DNA having an nucleotides that is called as A, T, G and C. The four letters that are present over the DNA that are acts like an genetic depictions called as four letter depiction of ATGC. So, ATGC it is combined with a protein. So, protein synthesis ke edo help maarte. Andra particular agi amino acid jote combined agi protein synthesis ke help maarte. So, second one. These are triplet codon system. Triplet codon system. So here the nitrogen bases they are written in the form of three nucleotides. So common agi nave entri four letters itu ATGC. ATGC eshtuke combined agbeku it must combined with 20 amino acids. But combined agakke combination illa. So hangagi George Gemmo annavantha scientist ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಪೋಸ್ ಮಾಡಿರೋದು ಏನು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸೊ ಯೂಶ್ವಲಿ ದ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯೋಟೈಡ್ಸ್ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ರಿಟರ್ನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಟ್ರಿಪ್ಲೆಟ್ ಕೋಡಾನ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸ್ ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ಎಷ್ಟೆಷ್ಟು ಬರಿಬೇಕು ಮೂರು ಸೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸ್ ಮಾತ್ರ ಬರಿಬೇಕು ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಎ ಟಿ ಜಿ ಜಿ ಸಿ ಎ ಟಿ ಜಿ ಸಿ ಈ ತರ ಸೊ ಈ ತರ ಮೂರ್ ಮೂರು ಸೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸ್ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಶೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಸೊ ಎಷ್ಟು ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ತೋರಿಸುತ್ತಪ್ಪ ಕೋಡಾನ್ಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಶೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ 64 ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ 64 combination बनते ATGC sequence था। इरो तो 20 amino acids, but is having an capacity they can be bind with these sequence. But 64 codons होते, it combined with amino acid इस्तेमाल है। So 61 codons, it only combines with amino acids. अरवत्तनारक combination ले, the 61 codons only having an capacity to combine with amino acid. That is necessary for protein synthesis. But the remaining three codons, they are not combined with any amino acids. So, yavade rithiyada amino acids jote kavu combined agala. So, hangagi they are called as an codon terminators. So, ishtu, that is a triplet codon system. Always the nucleotides, that is a nitrogen bases, they are always written in the form of three nucleotides. That is called as triplet codon system. So, next one. That is an codon is universal. Codon is universal. So universal is common. Illa kadenu onde tara irodu. So particularly, so specific amino acid, some particular codon combines with. Particular amino acid in all organisms. So this is called characteristic feature that was describing that the genetic code is universal. Genetic code is universal and explain madakka the particular codons it always combine with particular amino acid in all organisms. So for this example we can give the UUU. This is a triplet codon. So this particular codon, it combined with a particular amino acid that is called as phenylalanine in all organisms. In all organisms, bacteria agirbodu, eukaryotes agirbodu, all organisms UUU anuvantha codon phenylalanine and amino acid gene combined. So hangagi the codon is universal anuvantha features follow. So these each two features are there. Next one. Codons are degenerate and redundancy. So codons for degenerate and redundancy anna prasthiti. So what does this relates to? So here some amino acids combines with combines with more than one codon. So for instance, another one particular sum of the amino acids that having a capacity of combining with more than one codon. So this was relating to the codons of degenerate or redundancy. So next feature, it is an codons are unambiguous. Or and specific. So this was relating that one triplet codon it combines with one amino acid. One to codon, no? Yavaglu one day amino acid ke combine. So e feature na namen anta kariyivi that is an unambiguous and specific anta kariyivi. So next one. So codons are. So usually they are comma-less and non-overlapping. So usually the sequence that they are in the presence of triplet codon system, yavaglu continuous agi reading frame alli irutte. Yave rithiyada overlapping mechanism agli matte comma adirli adu punctuation marks agli navu sequence illa. So navu ugle barthe example ATG, GAT, CAT, ACC anta sequence bartu. Idu continuous agide. Yave rithiyada punctuation marks agli irilla. Ondru mele ondu sequence overlapping kuda nu agu. So hagagi idu ondu specific features alli navu mention maadidevi. So okay, next one. Helpful for to synthesize an amino acid. And the translation of start madakke help madovantha initiator codon enu. So common agi na rest codons galirutte combination illi 64. So the first initiator codon yavandre AUG. So AUG is an initiator codon that is helpful for initiating the protein synthesis when it was present at the starting region of an mRNA. So idu mRNA ta tagondre mRNA na first sequence yavandre agirutte AUG. So AUG it always combined with an amino acid that is called as methionine. So idu yava amino acid jothe combine agutte methionine jothe combine agutte. So this is called as initiator codon. So rare case alli AUG illa andre GUG has been replaced. Initiator codon andre enu give example kelthara initiator codon yado AUG is an initiator codon. So akasmat AUG illa andre rare case alli enagutte GUG. So GUG idaga yaru combine agutte valine amino acid combine agutte. So this is about an initiator codon. Next one kada terminator codon. Terminator codon athwa codon terminator codon terminator and even it is called as nonsense codon. So enu codon terminator athwa nonsense codons ante idiri. So among 64 combinations, 61 codons only having a capacity to combine with an amino acid and they are involved in translation. Whereas the remaining 3 codons, they are not combined with any amino acid. So they are resulting in the stop of a translation. A 3 codons in order to have a protein synthesis na stop marathe. So they are called as codon terminator or nonsense codon. So which are those 3 codons in the codon? There is an UAA. UAG and UGA. So these are the 3 codons which acts like a nonsense codon. So ishtu codon terminator na namu define made helpful. So ishtu characteristic features of a genetic code. So genetic code the characteristic features anta mention martta hodre. So yagadane helthivi. So first one, there is a 4 letter depiction. So usually the genetic code which consisting of an ATGC sequence anta karithira. ATGC sequence admele it always usually return in the form of three letter depiction. So yavaglu more nucleotides kalna navu jothege baribekagutte. So among those 64 combinations only the 61 combination having an capacity to combine with amino acid. The remaining they cannot. So in on the other next property. Third, so codes is universal anta karithira. So the particular amino acid combines with particular codon in all the organism. Example, phenylalanine it combined with UUU anta karithira. So next one, it was showing an there is a redundancy property where some of the amino acids they can also be combined with more than one codons anta kuda no karithira. So and it was specific. Codon is a specific or unambiguous. One codon, one amino acid jothe matra combined agutte anta ee process. And it was showing a commaless or non-overlapping reading frame anta en karithivi. The nucleotide sequence that they are present over the mRNA, it was continuously present. They are not showing any overlap, but there is no punctuation marks to separate those. So next one, the third one, that is an initiator codon. So the mRNA around the first sequence of naventa karthivi initiator codon yagagirutte AUG agirutte. It combines with methionine. In rare cases, if another AUG illade idaga GUG adu activity na start madutte, that is by combining with a valine. So terminator codon, so it stops the protein synthesis start madak help madudu initiator codon AUG help mulka. Protein synthesis stop madale adanda terminator codons, they are also called as nonsense codons. So we have andre UAA UAG UGA ee moodu sequence kala nenpikkodu. So this is about an salient features of a genetic code anta helthe. So ishtu ivattina class alli discussion nadesitu. So ivatte enu tilkondidivi now concepts, there is a transcription in eukaryotes, differentiation between transcription which occurs in prokaryotes and eukaryotes, reverse transcription, and the features of genetic code. So ivatte na assignment bandide. First one, describe the process of transcription. Describe the process of transcription in eukaryotes by diagrammatic representation. Diagrammatic representation. So eukaryote transcription process na diagram bardu adra bagge description step wise initiational enaitu elongational enaitu termination enaitu anta describe maadbekagutte. So idu 5 marks. So next one, differentiate between transcription. Differentiate between transcription in prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Differentiation between prokaryotes and eukaryotes. This is for females. So next, write about the terms. First one, polycystonic mRNA. Second one, monocystronic mRNA. So differentiate between the transcription in prokaryotes, eukaryotes, differentiation by Nepu. So minimum ali 3-6 are differentiation by Pudi. So 3-6. So write about the terms, that is about polycystonic mRNA and mono-systonic mRNA. So idu 2 marks tu. So in another question, there is a fourth question. Write a note on reverse transcription. Write a note on reverse transcription. So ishtu ivattina assignment questions. So ivattina class alli nimge enadru doubts kalidre clarification bekagide kelbodu. So artha agide ankondidini. So students, so assignment bena particular time alli neevu submit maadkodi. So okay, chenagi othkodi. Thank you.
Students, ivattu navu discuss madidantha concept that is a transcription in eukaryotes. Difference between the transcription that occurs in prokaryotes and eukaryotes. So adralli first transcription in prokaryotes navu previous class alli discuss madideve. Transcription in eukaryotes tu ondu schematic representation alli navu nortta idivi slide alli. So this is a double stranded DNA. So when it has been binded with an RNA polymerase enzyme, it was resulting an unwinding mechanism. So where the RNA, that is an hnRNA that has been synthesized, that consisting of an hexons and introns. The hexons are having an coding sequence, introns are having a non-coding sequence. So for this hnRNA, GPP cap 5' regionally, GPP cap kuda no addition agutte. By the process of splicing mechanism in the, so where the introns have been removed and the hexons have been joined together by the process called ligation. So idralli cap region GPP cap ante inge add agutho ade tara 3' region alli poly A tail addition aagta hogutte, andre A anuvantha sequence continuous agirodu adana navu poly adenylation anta karitevi. So where it is helpful for forming an functional mRNA. So now you prokaryotes alli nodidaga mRNA direct synthesis agiddu protein formation aayitu. Adre so eukaryotes alli it has been helpful for the formation into an messenger RNA, which involves an RNA splicing mechanism, polyadenylation process anta karitivi, and even a ligation process. So these are the mechanism that have been involved in this anta karibodu. So next one, that is an retroviral integration anta vidare. So what this process explains anta tagondre reverse transcription anta karitivi now. So eno reverse transcription, the process which involves the formation of DNA by the help of RNA. So idu viruses alli occur aguvantha process. So where the viral RNA by the process of reverse transcription, it forms an viral DNA. So this viral DNA, it incorporated into genome. So ee genome alli entry aadmele ee composition again it was undergoing transcription to form a DNA, and they are involved in the mechanism next to gene expression alli involve agutte anta karibodu.
So reverse transcription bagge nimge gotaitu, where it is a process which involves, usually it occurs in viruses. So RNA, viral RNA idu reverse transcription inda viral DNA synthesis agutte. Aa viral DNA so nucleus alli iro genomic DNA jothe entry aagli, by the process of transcription again viral RNA synthesis aagamadakke help madutte.
So next aspect navu ivattu discuss madidalli genetic code anta helidvi, hauda? So genetic code andre eno, that is an code language of a gene anta kardideve. So idanna specific aagi it has been usually written in the form of triplet codon anta kardideve, hoda? So illi the sequence that they are present on DNA, they are called as code. mRNA mele irodu codons, tRNA mele barodu anticodons anta ivattin class alli bardideve kuda navu. So namge gottiro prakara amino acids eshtida 20 amino acid. So irodu letters eshtidave 4 sequence. But ಆ 4 ಸೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸ್ 4 ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯೋಟೈಡ್ಸ್ ಗಳನ್ನ ಅರೇಂಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ನ ನಾವು ಟ್ರಿಪ್ಲೆಟ್ ಕೋಡಾನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬರೆದಾಗ ಸೊ ಇಷ್ಟು 64 ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಗಳು ನಮಗೆ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಅದನ್ನ ಹೆಂಗ್ ಬರ್ಕೋಬೇಕು, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲೆಟರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕೋಡಾನ್, ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಲೆಟರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಲೆಟರ್. ಸೊ ಕಾಮನ್ ಆಗಿ ನಮಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿರೋದು ಆರ್ ಎನ್ ಎ ಆಗಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಸೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸು ಯು ಸಿ ಎ ಜಿ ಅಂತ ಬರೆದಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ಅದೇ ಈ ಕಡೆ ಲೈನಲ್ಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಯು ಸಿ ಎ ಜಿ, ಪ್ರತಿ ಒಂದು ಕಾಲಮಲ್ಲಿ ಅಪಿಯರೆನ್ಸ್ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಯು ಸಿ ಎ ಜಿ, ಯು ಸಿ ಎ ಜಿ, ಯು ಸಿ ಎ ಜಿ ಮತ್ತು ಯು ಸಿ ಎ ಜಿ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಇದ್ರ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಬರೆಯೋದಾದರೆ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಯು ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಸ್ ಯು ಮತ್ತು ಈ ಯು ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಅದನ್ನು ಯು 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 ಅಂತ ಕರೆದ್ವಿ. ಸೊ ಮತ್ತೆ ಈ ಯು
ಇಕಡೆ ಮೇಲ್ಗಡೆ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಯು ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇಕಡೆ ಸಿ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆನ್ ಯು ಯು ಸಿ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಸೊ ಯು ಯು ಎ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಯು ಯು ಜಿ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಒನ್ ಸೊ ಈ ಥರ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಆಗಿ ನಾವು ರೋ ವೈಸ್ ಈ ಕಡೆ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲೆಟರ್ ಕೊಡ ಆನ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಲೆಟರ್ ಮತ್ತು ಥರ್ಡ್ ಲೆಟರ್ ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಈ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಆಗಿ ಅರೇಂಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ನ ನಾವು ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಹೋದರೆ 64 ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ಸ್ ತಗೋಬೋದು ಆ 64 ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ಸ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿರೋದು 61 ಇಟ್ ಕಂಬೈನ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಅನ್ ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫಿಕ್ ಅಮೈನೋ ಆಸಿಡ್ ದಟ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್ ಸಿಂಥಸಿಸ್ ಸೊ ವೆರ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ರಿಮೇನಿಂಗ್ 3 ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಆನ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅನ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನೇಟರ್ ಕೋಡಾನ್ ಸ್ಟೋ ಕೋಡಾನ್ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಅಥವಾ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್ ಸಿಂಥಸಿಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ನಾನ್ ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಕೋಡಾನ್ಸ್ ಯಾವು ಯು ಎ ಎ ಯು ಎ ಜಿ ಮತ್ತು ಯು ಜಿ ಎ ಹಂಗಾಗಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿ ತೋರಿಸಿದ್ರೆ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಅಂತ ಬರ್ತಿದೆ ವೇರ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್ ಸಿಂಥಸಿಸ್ ಸೊ ಜೆನೆಟಿಕ್ ಕೋಡೋದು ಫೀಚರ್ಸ್ಗಳು ಇವತ್ತು ಓದಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಟ್ರಿಪ್ಲೆಟ್ ಕೋಡಾನ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮಲ್ಲಿರೋದು ಫೋರ್ ಲೆಟರ್ ಡಿಪಿಕ್ಷನ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಲ್ ರಿಡಂಡೆನ್ಸಿ ಅನ್ಆಂಬಿಗ್ಯೂಸ್ ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫಿಕ್ ಕಾಮಾಲೆಸ್ ನಾನ್ ಓವರ್ಲ್ಯಾಪಿಂಗ್ ಇನಿಷಿಯೇಟರ್ ಕೋಡಾನ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನೇಟರ್ ಕೋಡಾನ್ ಸೊ ಇವತ್ತು ನಾವು ಇಷ್ಟು ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ಸ್ಗಳನ್ನ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಅದು ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಕ್ರಿಪ್ಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾರಿಯೋಡ್ಸ್ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸಿಯೇಷನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಕ್ರಿಪ್ಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಪ್ರೋ ಕ್ಯಾರಿಯೋಡ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾರಿಯೋಡ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಜೆನೆಟಿಕ್ ಕೋಡ್ ಮತ್ತು ಜೆನೆಟಿಕ್ ಕೋಡು ಸೊ ಇದನ್ನು ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫಿಕ್ ಆಗಿ ಯಾವ ಥರ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ತೋರಿಸ್ತೀವಿ ಇದು ಅದ್ರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಯಾವ್ಯಾವ ಅಮೈನೋ ಆ್ಯಸಿಡ್ಗೆ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಸೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸ್ಗಳು ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಸೊ ಅದನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ತೋರಿಸಿದ್ದೇವೆ ಅದ್ರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟು ಫೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಜೆನೆಟಿಕ್ ಕೋಡ್ ಸೊ ಇಷ್ಟು ನಾವಿವತ್ತು ಓದಿರೋ ಅಂಥ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಓಕೆ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಓದ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್